Hey fellow tennis nerds, I hope all is well. Today I wanted to talk about tennis balls. Usually we talk about rackets and strings and all things in between, pro players, what they use and so on, but we don't really get into balls. And it's a topic I want to put more importance on because it is a very important topic. And do you know what balls you generally use and why you use them? Have you ever given that any kind of thought? Do you go for a kind of a budget ball or a premium ball? Let me know in the comments below. I'm quite curious about this topic. I'm pretty picky with balls. I've become so over the years. I usually buy a box of 18 to 24 cans of balls, always pressurized. That's my main recommendation. Pay a few extra euros or dollars if you can for the balls. You're going to be happy about that because you're going to get better durability, better consistency in bounce, and just a better playability and feel from the tennis ball. So I definitely think it's a thing you should pay a bit more attention and pay a little bit more for. It's generally not that much more for a premium ball. But there are many kinds of tennis balls. Let's go through them each. First, kids tennis balls. They are obviously a bit different. When they're age 3 to 5, they should play with foam balls. That's very important. And then ages 6 to 8 should go with red dot balls, ages 9 to 10, orange dot balls, and ages 11 to 13 should go with green dot balls. These are all recommendations. Obviously, it might depend a little bit on the physicality and how much the kid plays and so on, but be a bit careful with heavy balls and the kind of strings your kid uses because it might lead to injuries. So don't put in a poly at a high tension in a 12-year-old's rack. I don't think that's a great idea. So those are kids' balls, but what are the different options for us recreational tennis nerds? There are mainly three different levels of balls. So the first level is pressurized premium balls. Those are the balls you should go for in my recommendations. Those are the ones I use. A few examples, Wilson US Open, Head Tour, XT, Technifiber balls, Yonex Tour 1. There are many premium balls. I like Dunlop Fort All Court as well. Many good balls to choose from there. We'll get into that a bit later. But there's also championship balls. So if you see championship, the word, that's a pretty premium word. It sounds nice, but this is kind of the middle ground ball. They are pressurized, meaning that they have air or gas in them, but they are kind of a hole punch construction. It's not the premium feel, synthetic fibers instead of the natural wool fibers. So it's not a really premium experience. They're going to be a little bit less durable, not going to give that nice playability of the premium balls, but they're much better in my opinion than playing with pressureless balls, which is the third category of ball. So the pressureless balls, they have no pressure inside, generally much harder and heavier. Not so great for the arm, that's one thing. Just for fun, I bought a bunch of different balls. I will talk more about that on the channel to test. And the pressureless balls, we could only play with for like 15 minutes. They were too hard, it didn't bounce properly, it just skidded through the court. Wasn't a very nice experience. And I paid for a nicer pressureless ball, so it wasn't a cheap one. So the pressureless balls is something I probably stay away from. I haven't tried Trinity or Trinity Pro from Wilson, so I can't say if they're bad or not. So the Trinity Pro are new, so it will be interesting to see how they play. There are different kinds of pressureless balls, but I would recommend you to get a pressurized ball. Premium balls are also different. There are some livelier balls, for example. I would say Babolat Technifiber, Wilson US Open, so they're a little bit livelier than the balls I tend to go for. I kind of like heavier balls like the Head Tour XT, that's kind of a tour ball, and a Dunlop Fort All Court. I kind of prefer the heavier ball. If you have a flatter game, a heavier ball might suit you better because there's less liveliness and you get more control. But if you play with more spin, you might like a livelier ball that bounces higher, so you get an extra kick on your shot. So it all depends. You also have to take into consideration the temperature and the playing conditions. If you're playing on a clay court, the balls will last longer. You can go for regular duty. But if you're playing on a hard court outside, like the courts I'm playing on in Malta are pretty harsh on balls and shoes, you would go for an extra duty, meaning a little bit of a thicker felt, a little bit of a heavier ball will last longer on those courts. And for example, if you're playing in very cold outdoor situation, you might like the livelier ball to offset the cold weather, because cold weather creates a pretty dead ball, pretty dead atmosphere, heavy on the arm. Get a livelier ball to offset the heavy conditions. And if you're playing in sunny, humid conditions, there's a lot of action on the balls, a lot of bounce, you should probably get a heavier, deader ball to give yourself a bit more control and longer rallies and so on. So there are many things to take into consideration. There's a reason pro players are so picky about balls. You might have seen a few years back that Rafa didn't like the balls in the at the French Open. I think it was the 2020 edition, played in September. So if, for example, you have heavy balls in really heavy condition, cold, how are you going to hit the winner? The rallies will be endless and so on. So the players will be frustrated. So all these things are important. If you're playing on a super fast court and condition, you don't want to have a super fast ball. So it's a little bit tricky, this whole situation, because the balls they use at tournaments are kind of the sponsored balls. So the players don't really have a say, and maybe the tournament organization, they just need money. So it's a bit tricky to get that perfect match of the ball and the tournament. It's something they think about for sure, but sometimes it gets a little bit wrong, and some players are pissed off. But it all depends on their playing style, of course, and what kind of feel and ball they prefer overall. But the balls play a big role in how the tennis is played. So pay attention to it. I definitely recommend that. How long do balls last? Well, the pressureless balls, they can last a really long time. You can play with them for a long time. That's their main selling point. But it's not going to be the most enjoyable experience, in my opinion. I tend to play with balls about 3-4 hours in total. So I play 2 sessions of 90 minutes. But I'm playing on pretty rough hard courts. So the balls are pretty gone at that time. They don't have much bounce left. They're a little bit worn overall, so they're not nice to play with. You have to hit many good shots to hit a winner. It can be quite tedious to play with these deader balls. So we try to keep a good rotation, put a bit of effort into that. And it costs a bit more, obviously, to keep changing balls, but it does really improve the level of tennis and the enjoyment you're getting out of the tennis. So I definitely put a bit of premium on that. So some good premium balls that I can recommend: the Head Tour XT, Dunlop Fort All Court, Wilson US Open are pretty decent as well. The RS balls, the new RS balls, the white or black cans, they're nice balls. Really like them. Also enjoyed the new Yonex, a little bit livelier than I usually prefer, but I did like the Yonex Tour 1. Didn't last as long as some of the ones I regularly use, but was nicer straight out of the box. So there are many good balls out there. Pen, I haven't tried these, but I hear many good things about Pen balls. So check those out. But I tend to recommend to go for a pressurized premium ball and buy a box. You know, you can share it with someone maybe if you don't want to pay the whole cost for it. But it's definitely important to play with relatively fresh balls and balls that are of good quality. It's going to improve your tennis and you're going to get more enjoyment. There are also high altitude balls. If you're playing 4,000 feet above sea level, on a high altitude, the air is thinner, the balls are flying more, bouncing more. You can get balls with less air pressure or pressureless balls to kind of, you know, offset that and get a more balanced experience. So there are also high altitude balls. So there is a choice for you, depending on the condition, on your playing style, level, and what you're looking for in your tennis ball. So hopefully you get a bit more knowledge about tennis balls. I'll dive deeper into it. I'll review the Wilson Trinity and other upcoming balls soon. What ball is your favorite? What do you use and why? Let me know in the comments below. If you want to support the work I do, check out patreon.com/tennisnerd or my affiliates. The links are in the description. Big thanks if you buy anything through those. I get a small commission. All goes into making better content for you and from Tennis Nerd. That's it. Have a nice day and don't forget to play some tennis.